breaking live at a sold-out Boone Pickens Stadium, where the Oklahoma State Cowboys are ready to give the BCS voters a reason for why the Cowboys belong in the BCS title game. Tonight in primetime, Oklahoma State hosts a strong Kansas State Wildcat team.
His officials, none of them felt it at all. In fact, Mike Gundy told me he didn't even know about it until I told him. He said, I don't watch TV, don't listen to the radio. People don't talk to me on game day.
So the freshman Josh Stewart brings it out to the 32.
I was in Tuscaloosa. This offense, Dana Holgorsen last year brought it from Houston. He's now the head coach at West Virginia. Todd Monken is now running this show, and Brandon Wheaton's doing a great job.
And Herschel Sims, the talented freshman, checks on as they throw the first pass to Joseph Randall.
But let man on the reverse, just try to get them settled into the game early.
Use the running game with Randall short of that first down. Now, this is an important point in this game. RBD, Oklahoma State's base 4-3. Bring a safety up close to the box. And there's that read option. Klein fumbles the ball.
There they
ball
go.
Fumble, first and goal. And there is another takeover. That is their 13th fumble recovery. That is their 30th overall turnover. Fullback. He is off to the left in this full house set. This is power to the left, and here comes Randall in that direction. End zone, touchdown. Joseph Randall with the first score of the game. And the Cowboys jump ahead as, again, they take advantage of the 30th turnover. Sharp, as we told you, does everything. Tacks on the extra point.
So, and an early turnover if you just turned over to take a peek at the number three team in the country. And it was a nice completion for a first down. Sitting third and six, just shy of midfield. Klein again forced out of the pocket. Fires, deflected in the air and out of bounds, incomplete. And the Wildcats are forced to punt.
Nick, if Kansas State drops back to throw, Blacknick will put a lot of pressure on him. Already 7 sacks this year.
Second down, wide open. And that time, they go to
game, and it got the linebacker out of position.
Play action. Wheaton has great time. Fires downfield. Got another open target. It's Moore again. And Moore is into the red zone. You talk about a prolific hold. The ball was put down. Kansas State has the football running out of bounds.
Yeah, right towards the just the very end. I mean, he's fighting for every yard. He's down for sure. Eyes, which is important when it comes to the chemistry of a football team.
He's taking golf. He plays out at Carston Creek Golf Club. Have a great golf program here. And there he is hitting it 3 times in a row. Tracy Moore on first. Soft coverage on him. Quick throw to him because it was soft. Strength, touchdown. You can't play him that soft because you're not going to be able to tackle him. That's how strong he is. 6'1", 215 pounds, junior from Ardmore, Oklahoma.
Corner on an island.
Here's Quinn Sharp again. Tacking it on. So he's got 5 targets, split out wide, trying to pick up the 7. And it's deflected, and they'll be forced to punt it again. So here comes Ryan Doerr to punt it again. He hung the last one really up in the air. Blackman's going to take a crack. Fumble! Dive for the loose ball. Remember, Blackman juggled the first one on the fair catch. And we will let the officials sort this out. Put the ball on the ground. Kansas State comes away. That's Herzog underneath, number 59. And hands the ball to the referee.
Klein's ability to run the football.
And Klein tripped up at the 20-yard line, a loss. And let's see if Snyder goes for the field goal. Nick, it's a 37-yard attempt. This young man hit a 54-yarder last week back in Manhattan. And so Kansas State takes it.
Severe injury that he suffered. Scored a touchdown against Baylor the other day. Play action. Wheaton sets, fires downfield, and picked off at the 24-yard line by Hartman. And it's picked up by the young man from Wichita.
And they're going to bring an end around. Double reverse Lockett. Klein is out blocking. Lockett to the 50. Lockett breaks free to the 30. Cuts back to the 20. And Lockett finally run out of bounds inside the 5-yard line. He's seen something he thinks he can take advantage of here. He sprints outside. Touchdown, Kansas State. So down by 14, the Wildcats put 9, and they're an extra point away from 10. Cantelli will add the extra point.
Easy there for Peace to get upfield for that touchdown.
So turnovers are killing Oklahoma State.
So it's 3rd and 7 here, still in the first quarter. Bounce, one hop. They'll be forced to punt. So Kansas State has turned things.
Need 5 on this 3rd down, and they've got it. Complete to the 37-yard line to Tremaine Thompson.
Make the throw.
Klein going deep. Got a receiver caught at the 18-yard line. Thompson again, the young man from another at the 16-yard line, and knocking on the door. Klein, a keeper. And he slams to the 9-yard line, and Jones makes the stop for the Cowboys. 9 yards offense for K-State to 112 for Oklahoma State. Klein with that quick pitch, slip screen outside, and it'll be a 1st and goal. Sexton, the freshman from Kansas.
On running with it.
And he is a very good runner. Very dangerous down here in the red zone. Here he comes. Klein battling. Touchdown. Kansas State leads it. Colin Klein takes it into the end zone. And he has 17 rushing touchdowns. Can that possibly? He tacks on the extra point after for this return for Justin. Intercepted, headed for the end zone, Wheaton after him, and it's going to be an Alan Chapman touchdown. How about this, ladies and gentlemen? 2 picks thrown by Wheaton, and 1's a pick 6, and we got something brewing in Stillwater. And as the result, the Wildcats have jumped all over the number 3 team. Folks, they don't even look in Blackman's direction this time. He comes up over the top, and he hits Josh.
Backers, Arthur Brown that time in coverage.
Empty backfield. Now Wheaton waits for somebody to come free, and in the middle, he's got a 1st down at the 31-yard line with Mike
Free, the outside linebacker.
Wheaton off the play action, the middle again. For 1st and 10 at the 20-yard line, Tracy
behind him in coverage.
Now here's Wheaton again. Blackman to the 6-yard line, and it'll be 1st down and goal on 3rd and goal. And Blackman again, one-on-one off to the right, but they've shown no indication they're going to throw. He does this time, fade the other side, and incomplete. Garrett, this will be a 19-yard field goal, and if he makes it, he will snap that 24 unanswered streak by the Wildcats, and he nails it. Sends it through. But the dog, still plenty of the time at following his changeup. Now we're going to see him throw it. Comes to the sideline, deflected, intercepted on the deflection. Another turnover. Thomas, the linebacker, he got a convoy down the sideline, and the Cowboys are in business. The ball is going to be spotted inside the 10-yard line.
And State comes up with a big turnover.
Wildcats it down to the last one. Wheaton again, firing touchdown. Easy that time to Tracy Moore, the junior from down the road in Tulsa.
Credit there to Justin Blackman for getting a lot of attention and setting that up for more behind the coverage.
Man, you're sharp. We're back where we started her. There's a 3rd down for Klein and the Wildcats. Deflected, and they'll be forced to punt. High in the 1st half.
You're watching number three Oklahoma State right now with its hands full against Kansas State. We have just about 3 minutes remaining to the first half, and breaking free is Tracy Moore, who has been the big go-to receiver tonight for Oklahoma State.
This tempo and trying to avoid the fatigue that can set in facing this kind of offense.
So Whedon from the gun fires complete. When he works to that side,
a window to be able to throw behind Malone, and an easy throw for Brandon Whedon.
Off a play fake, Whedon comes firing back, and here's Blackman. And Blackman dives across the five wide receivers. And it's deflected. That should be field goal time. They have a very good, the 20-yard line. So very close to a 30-yard attempt here. And the Cowboys regain the lead. And they close the tight end down to the right. Tannehill. Klein, flush, going to be sacked at the 23-yard line by Caleb Levy. Arm injury, and so that forced him out of baseball. He'd already been offered a scholarship here in football, and he decided to take him up on it. And here he is, firing complete. And Tracy Moore working the middle, makes another grab. He's been his most...
Nine. So far, we've not seen Josh Cooper. He's not played at all tonight.
Oh, there's that flash in the round with Josh Stewart, the freshman. And he is out of bounds at the 36-yard.
Texas has the speed to be able to execute that.
Now the power run, first down for Randall, and Randall is down to the 31-yard line.
Oh, and then they'll start to attack throwing the football vertically as well.
Play action fake. Whedon fires and going to be thrown out of bounds.
And again, Josh Cooper not playing tonight. Others have had to step up, and they're willing to do it and able to do it.
There's that slip screen to Randall. Touchdown, Oklahoma State. That's the third touchdown pass of the night for Brandon Whedon.
About everything you can do, and they march right down the field, six plays and 62 yards for the touchdown.
So Oklahoma Klein and the Wildcats. Quick throw, and they got a first down, and there is Andre McDonald. You know what Coach Young said about this? There's Lockett. Came back and took the handoff. And Lockett for the first down. Breaks free. 35-30. And he is down to the 26-yard line. Martin making the lone. Checks the sideline. Five receivers are out on this second and goal. Drops it off. Lockett. Touchdown as he dives across. The freshman from Tulsa.
Brent.
And now on is Anthony Cantelli for the extra point. And Kansas State bounces back again. They trade. The freshman is down at the 35. Here comes Randall, be the running back behind Whedon. Play action, stands tall, comes middle, Blackman, and here he comes. Not fumbling this one, first down at the 42-yard line.
Pushing here against the Wildcats.
The ball is at the 38-yard line for Whedon. They run the draw with Randall. Got the first down. And Moore as he goes to the 28-yard line. Quick pitch. And Ty Moore. Tracy Moore, the receiver, number 87. He's been active here tonight.
Well, he has had a pass throwing right behind the two linebackers into the middle of the defense.
You're fired to Randall. And he is down at the 23-yard line of the 29. And now this is longest of the night. Here comes a 40-yarder. Trying to make it 3 of 3. Curls it right in beautifully. First down and 10. And they'll run Klein behind Power this time. Man, he's got about nine.
Checks the sideline. Shovel pass inside and a beautifully read and designed play for a first down to the 30-yard line. You got to hurry now on that play clock. Pitch the option, and Hubert's cut off for a loss. And it's a terrific play by Alex Elkins. Elkins down by six on a fourth and seven. Klein dances away. He's got daylight. First down to the 13-yard line. When it opened up to the left, Klein field goals. Strength is to the right. Hubert is there behind Wilson. Second down and seven. Klein going to keep it himself. Cuts and short of that first down marker with Lowe making the stop. Option, Klein end zone. An extra point away from leading number three. Stanford, Boise State on full alert right now.
The previous third down.
And here's Cantelli for the lead. And Kansas State regains the lead.
Now they answer that touchdown drive by Kansas State.
Empty the backfield. Wheaton fires in underneath, complete to Randall, a running back. And he picks up a first down line.
Very impressed with how Brandon Wheaton has bounced back from some adversity and turnovers that he has had. He still had a pretty solid night in this game.
Wide open, there's Blackman. Blackman dancing for the end zone. Gave one up and got one back. That is Justin Blackman, just what the coaches told us. A 54-yard touchdown pass. And here they go for two. He's going to try to throw for it again. Got him all alone. Same man hands it to the referee. How are you going to stop the big fella? Got a here. Lockett driven back to the goal line. 15-20. Looking for a seam on that left side. And he's at the 40. Breaks free. Lockett running for the end zone. Tripped up down at the 20. That's, oh my.
Down.
So dangerous as a runner. They got two downs to make this. He'll keep it on third. He's got the first. Breaks free. End zone. Touchdown. What an extra point away from a tie.
He's able to cut back.
The kickoff return by Lockett. And now we are deadlocked at 45 on Contelli's extra. Now 3-11. And let's see if Wheaton can strike again. Back middle. Got it. Complete. Throws it now.
Other side for a huge play.
Wheaton back again. Here's Blackman. Got it one-on-one. Shoves the DB aside. Why he's so strong. Puts out.
Look what we've
every
got here.
Week we get these games.
2:22 now, Herbie. Third down and one. And they got it. Randall breaks free. End zone. Oklahoma State regains the lead. Joseph Randall breaks in. But there's a lot of time for the Never Quit Kids from Manhattan. Seven-point lead again. Here is Klein. Back. Takes off. Running for the first down. And he will step out of bounds at the 40-yard line and stop. One timeout. Klein will try to run for it. He's got the first down.
Now you hurry up. You save the timeout. There's
no spike it? Or do you keep going? Final 19 seconds. Kansas State down seven. Klein, gonna fire to the corner, caught out of bounds. That was Chris Harper working the sideline to the, got one timeout to go if they can't get this in. Klein, back to throw for it, looks, fade, end zone, knocked away beautifully in the corner, and that was Martin. Martin went after. Klein, fire. Lopez, end zone, knocked away. With 1 second left on the clock. Klein rolls to the right. Fires high and incomplete, and Oklahoma State will survive a scare. 52-45, one of the guttiest performances we've seen by quarterback Colin Klein and the Kansas State Wildcats, coached by Bill Snyder. Unlike a week ago at home, tonight they went out guns blazing. But in the end, the number three team survives.